The armored personnel carrier with modular armor, capable of moving on both land and water. Is it science fiction or the reality of today? How are modern developments changing the concept of combat and security on the battlefield? Be sure to stay with us until the end to learn about the most incredible military technologies of our time. Enjoy watching. WAHASH. I'd like to begin with WAHASH, the latest multi-purpose armored vehicle with an 8x8 wheel configuration, developed by the defense company Calidus from the United Arab Emirates in collaboration with South Africa's ADG Mobility. This vehicle is designed to tackle a wide range of combat missions, including participation in combat operations, reconnaissance, and counterinsurgency. WAHASH exhibits impressive mobility and survivability in challenging terrains and extreme climates, making it indispensable in the most difficult combat zones. The vehicle is equipped with modern weaponry, including a 30mm automatic cannon, a 7.62mm machine gun, a 30mm automatic grenade launcher, and 6 smoke grenade launchers that help conceal movements during combat. Additionally, 2 anti-tank missile launchers significantly enhance its combat capabilities against enemy armored vehicles. WAHASH offers a high level of crew protection, adhering to STANAG 4569 Level 4, which ensures reliable ballistic protection against firearms and explosions. It is also protected against landmine detonations and improvised explosive devices at levels 4A and 4B, making it resilient to modern battlefield threats. This vehicle can transport up to 12 people, including the crew, and features an adaptable platform for mounting various weapons and equipment, making it versatile for a wide range of missions. TULPAR. At the DSEI exhibition in 2019, Turkey showcased an upgraded version of the TULPAR light tank and infantry fighting platform developed by Otokar. This conceptual vehicle was designed with international requirements in mind, making it attractive to foreign buyers. The prototype of the infantry fighting vehicle was first presented in 2013 and the light tank in 2018. One of TULPAR's main innovations is the serral turret mounted on the tank, along with an improved automatic loading system capable of firing all types of NATO 105mm ammunition. This expands the vehicle's tactical capabilities and allows it to adapt to various combat scenarios. A key feature of the platform is its modular armor, which can be upgraded depending on the threat level, up to STANAG level 5. This provides additional flexibility in protecting both the crew and the vehicle on the battlefield. The TULPAR's hull offers a high level of mine protection thanks to a mine-resistant welded structure and shock-absorbing seats, which reduce crew injuries from explosions. This makes the vehicle suitable for operations in areas where mines and improvised explosive devices are a threat. Under the hood, the TULPAR is powered by a V8 diesel engine with turbocharging and water cooling, delivering 720 horsepower. This gives the vehicle high mobility and maneuverability, essential for rapid response in combat situations. ZAHA. Turkey is currently actively constructing its first universal landing ship, and as part of this program, advanced combat vehicles are being developed under the ZAHA project. The first result is an amphibious armored personnel carrier, which will form the basis for 2 more types of armored vehicles. The ZAHA's armored hull resembles traditional designs, but includes several unique differences. It is made of an aluminum-magnesium alloy with ceramic inserts, providing high ballistic protection while maintaining a relatively lightweight structure. A crucial element is its mine protection, significantly increasing the survivability of the vehicle and its crew in modern combat conditions. ZAHA is powered by a Caterpillar C-13 engine with over 600 horsepower, which, in combination with an Allison automatic transmission, gives it high mobility both on land and water. This makes the vehicle ideal for amphibious operations, ensuring rapid deployment and support for offensive actions. Various combat modules can be installed on the roof of the armored vehicle, allowing it to be adapted to specific tasks. The prototype ZAHA is equipped with a combat module from FNSS, featuring a 40mm automatic grenade launcher and a heavy machine gun. The ZAHA project demonstrates Turkey's commitment to strengthening its defense capabilities, particularly in amphibious technology, with a focus on modern standards of protection and mobility. YAGU. YAGU is the latest ultralight tactical armored vehicle developed by the Israeli company Plasan, designed specifically for the needs of special operations forces and military units around the world. This vehicle is built to perform a wide range of missions, including special operations, border patrol, urban combat, and reconnaissance tasks. Thanks to its versatility and lightweight, YAGU is perfect for operations in diverse environments that require high mobility and quick response. One of YAGU's key advantages is the use of composite materials for its armor. This has reduced the vehicle's weight to just 2,500 pounds, making it one of the lightest in its class. Despite this, the vehicle provides a high level of protection, meeting the B6 Plus standard, capable of withstanding even rifle rounds and fire from AK-47s. Such reliable protection makes YAGU an effective tool for combat missions in high-risk environments. The vehicle is equipped with a remotely controlled combat module mounted on the roof. Depending on the mission's requirements, the module can be fitted with a machine gun, automatic grenade launcher, or other weaponry. YAGU combines advanced technologies, lightness, and high protection, making it an ideal platform for modern military operations. This vehicle represents a significant step forward in the development of next-generation tactical equipment. Hunter. Hunter is the latest combat armored vehicle recently commissioned by the Singapore Army. According to the Brigadier General of the Singapore Armed Forces, Hunter is the first fully computerized vehicle, combining modern digital technologies with the needs of soldiers. The vehicle is designed to enhance combat capabilities and crew protection, while also improving the efficiency of operations in modern combat environments. Hunter's body is made of steel armor, which can be supplemented with additional armor to enhance ballistic protection. The armor meets STANAG 4569 Level 4, providing a high degree of protection against small arms fire and shrapnel. A key feature is the ability to control all vehicle systems via touch screens, greatly simplifying the crew's interaction with weapons and other functions. Hunter's armament includes a 30mm automatic cannon, capable of effectively engaging armored targets at medium and long ranges, a 7.62mm machine gun, and two launchers for guided missiles, increasing the vehicle's capability against heavy enemy equipment. This combat vehicle is designed with high mobility, protection, and adaptability in mind, allowing it to be used in various tactical scenarios. Hunter not only embodies the latest technologies, but also serves as an example of integrating digital systems into the modern military. KORKUT. KORKUT is a self-propelled anti-aircraft defense system developed by the Turkish company Aselsan in collaboration with FNSS for the Turkish Army. The system is based on the ACV-30 armored combat platform, which provides mobility and protection on the battlefield. KORKUT is designed to detect, track, identify, and destroy various aerial threats, making it a crucial element of air defense in modern warfare. The system's main feature is a remotely controlled turret mounted on the vehicle's roof, equipped with two stabilized 35mm KDC cannons. These guns can effectively engage a wide range of aerial threats, including air-to-ground missiles, cruise missiles, unmanned aerial vehicles, as well as low-flying helicopters and aircraft. The maximum target engagement range is up to 12,000 feet, making KORKUT a powerful tool for protecting troops and critical infrastructure. The system's armor is made of steel and aluminum, providing STANAG 4569 Level 4 ballistic protection against small arms fire and Level 2 protection against explosions. The vehicle can withstand an explosion of up to 18 pounds of TNT under its tracks, significantly enhancing its resistance to landmines and improvised explosive devices. KORKUT is a versatile air defense solution capable of operating in various environments and countering numerous modern threats, making it a vital asset for the Turkish army in defending against aerial attacks. Arcus Trapper. Arcus Trapper is a multi-purpose military transport vehicle developed by Arcus, formerly Renault Trucks Defense, designed to carry out various military tasks, such as transporting cargo, patrolling, command, and communications. It is widely used by the French Army and is known for its versatility and reliability. The Trapper is based on the Ford Everest chassis, which provides strength and adaptability in the toughest conditions. For combat missions, the Trapper is equipped with reinforced bumpers and military-grade protection that meets NATO standards. The vehicle's sturdy body ensures reliable protection for the crew and equipment, making it suitable for missions in high-threat zones. Inside, the vehicle can accommodate up to 5 soldiers, making it useful for transporting personnel in conflict areas. The Trapper's technical specifications are also impressive. The vehicle is powered by a 160-horsepower diesel engine that meets Euro 3 environmental standards, making it efficient and economical to operate. High ground clearance and special off-road tires give the Trapper excellent off-road capability and stability on challenging terrain. The vehicle's maximum speed is 90 miles per hour, allowing for rapid movement even in rugged areas. The Trapper is the ideal solution for a wide range of missions, combining reliability, power, and mobility, making it a valuable asset for modern military operations. Flyer. Flyer is a light tactical wheeled vehicle developed and produced in collaboration between General Dynamics and Flyer Defense to meet the needs of U.S. Special Operations Command. This transportable vehicle combines compact size with high functionality, making it ideal for carrying out a variety of military tasks. Flyer is equipped with a unique ring-mounted weapons system, providing 360-degree coverage, allowing the crew to effectively respond to threats from any direction. A turret on the roof is armed with a 12.7mm heavy machine gun, which can be replaced with a 40mm automatic grenade launcher if needed. To further increase firepower, each door of the vehicle can be additionally fitted with a swivel station for mounting a 5.56mm or 7.62mm machine gun. Flyer is also offered in an armored configuration with a 4-door cabin, providing B6 level protection, significantly enhancing crew safety in combat zones. This feature makes Flyer a versatile solution for both light operations and missions in more dangerous environments. The vehicle is powered by a 2-liter engine producing 150 horsepower. The engine is paired with a 6-speed automatic transmission, ensuring smooth and efficient gear transitions. Flyer represents the perfect balance between mobility, firepower, and protection, making it an indispensable tool for modern special operations. PL-01. To conclude, let me introduce a very unusual prototype of a Polish tank, presented back in 2013 as an invisible tank, promising revolutionary stealth technologies. The entire body of the vehicle was expected to be covered with special material that would absorb radar waves and provide thermal camouflage. The Swedish CV90-120T light tank was chosen as the development base, ensuring a combination of reliability and modern features. According to the stated specifications, the tank was equipped with a 120mm gun, compatible with standard NATO rounds, and capable of launching guided missiles. A unique feature of the tank was its unmanned, remotely controlled turret, allowing for safe firing from inside the vehicle. The tank could reach speeds of up to 30 miles per hour over rough terrain, and had a range of up to 300 miles, making it an excellent choice for mobile operations, with engine power reaching about 940 horsepower. At present, there is little recent news about the PL-01 project, leading many experts and media outlets to speculate that the development faced serious challenges and may have failed. However, the PL-01 tank gained some popularity in the gaming industry, appearing in games like GTA 5, which has fueled interest in the concept among military technology enthusiasts. Despite its uncertain future, the PL-01 remains an intriguing example of an innovative approach to armored vehicle design. Yes, these modern developments are truly impressive. By the way, which vehicle did you find the most surprising? Share your thoughts in the comments. And I have a proposal for you. We are looking for scriptwriters, voice actors, editors, and creative producers for our videos. Interested? Then follow the link in the description and submit your application. Thanks for watching.